Hello guys, today we are talking about what is chemistry. So if you ask me, I'm gonna tell you that chemistry is everything. Okay, hear me out. Let's imagine that we are on the beach. Okay, what would you do on the beach? Maybe go for a swim, maybe nap a little bit, maybe just have some fun with your friends. Well, this is me on the beach, drawing molecules into the sand. Well, I clearly really love chemistry. So what is the definition, the real definition of chemistry? Chemistry is the science of matter. It is the study of the properties and the changes that matter undergoes. Okay, but what is matter? Matter is anything that has mass and takes up space. So I was basically right. Because almost everything that we deal with in our daily lives has some mass and takes up space. The exceptions might be light or heat energy, right? So what are the building blocks of matter? The building blocks of matter are atoms, okay? Atoms here in this figure are represented with these little spheres. Okay? They are like little spheres. And an element is going to be a substance that is composed of one type of atom, okay? So the elements are found in the periodic table. As of 2020, so this year, we have 118 known elements in the periodic table. So here you can see atoms, which are the atoms of one type of an element. What happens if you have several atoms together? Well, if you have the same type of atoms stick together, like here, we are still going to have an element, but in this case, we are going to have molecules of that element, okay? Now, what happens when you start mixing together the different types of atoms? In that case, like in this picture, where we have this little white spheres, those are hydrogen atoms, and these little red spheres, those are oxygen atoms, and maybe you already guessed this is going to be H2O, since we have two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom, we are going to have molecules of a compound. So compounds are made up of at least two types of different elements, okay? So now all these three types of matter are going to be pure substances, okay? And what is a substance? A substance is going to have a distinct property and the composition that does not vary from sample to sample. So this means that if I have water, which is H2O on Earth, it's also going to be H2O anywhere in the universe. Okay? So on any other planet, H2O is going to be water. All right. Now, what happens if we mix together the different types of atoms, molecules, or compounds? Well, we will get so-called mixtures, okay? There are two types of mixtures that we have to consider. So let's look at the first picture right here. You can see that you can distinguish between the atoms of this element right here. Those are the blue little spheres, and you can distinguish between the molecules of water, right? They are in different places in this picture. So this means that the composition of this material is not the same through though. So we are going to call mixtures like this heterogeneous, okay? And if the composition is the same, so you have randomly mixed together water molecules with the atoms of an element, you are going to get a so-called homogeneous mixture. Okay? So this is the classification of matter based on its composition. Now, let's try to answer a question. Let's classify the following matters based on their composition. Okay, which one should we start with? Let's start with a pizza. Okay, do you think whether this is going to be some kind of pure substance, an element or a molecule, or is it going to be a mixture? Well, if it's a pure substance, then I would have to think about elements. Do we have an element named pizza? That would be fun, but unfortunately we do not, right? And actually, if you look at a pizza, you can see where is the pepperoni, and where are the olives and all the other parts, and where is the crust, right? So it's not the same composition everywhere. So this means that we are going to have a mixture which is going to be a heterogeneous mixture. Okay, I'm still hungry. Let's talk about ice cream. Okay, there is the ice cream. Do we have one type of pure substance, an element or a compound, or do we have things mixed together in a way? It's going to be a mixture, right? We have different ingredients there. Well, what if I have pieces of chocolate in that chocolate ice cream? I really like that. Well, I'm going to get again a heterogeneous mixture. All right, let's move on to this picture right here. So that shiny liquid is actually mercury. Okay, so this is mercury. And do you guys know what mercury is? It's not the planet. It's actually an element which has the symbol Hg. Okay, so I just said it's an element. So it's probably a pure substance. Okay, so it is a pure substance, an element named mercury. All right, let's look at this picture now. So we have here water, drinking water. So what does drinking water consist of? Is it only water molecules, or do we have other minerals in it? We are going to have other minerals in it. Do you see the minerals floating around here somewhere, or are they not visible at all? They are not visible, right? So this means that even though we have a mixture, the composition of water is going to be the same through dough. So we are going to have a homogeneous mixture. Now what happens if I'm talking about seawater, right? Water in the ocean, water in the sea. Would it be also a homogeneous mixture, or would it be something else? Well, we definitely have water molecules in seawater. We also have salt in it, so it's definitely a mixture. But do you see those gas bubbles all over? And then you are going to have the sand and the dirt floating around. So you will actually find spots where you have not only water, but other things too, like gas bubbles and some dirt, right? So this is going to be a heterogeneous mixture. I hope this makes sense. See you in the next video.